8 weeks. We dunking, baby.
Yo, what's up, guys? I'm Q. And for my entire life, I always wondered what it would be like to fly through the rim like Michael Jordan in the NBA dunk contest, tongue out and everything. I come from a basketball family, so dunking runs in my blood. But since I'm only 5'8", it's been a little more difficult for me. So for the last 8 weeks, I've been learning to dunk with NBA specialist trainer Paul Favorites. And tomorrow's our final assessment to see how much higher I'm jumping now versus when we first started. But before we get to that, I want to show you guys everything we've been through for the past 2 months to get me to where I am today.
I'm Coach Paul Favorites, and I'm an NBA performance specialist. When NBA players want to jump higher, run faster, get more explosive, and prevent injuries, they come to my gym. We work with athletes of all ages, so youth athletes, college, pre-draft, and all the way up to your favorite NBA superstars. Today, we're taking Quentin through our initial assessment. So step one is a functional movement screen. I gotta make sure that Quentin is moving the right way. I gotta find out if he has any mobility or stability limitations that we need to focus on during the program. From there, we're gonna go into our force plate assessments. So I have our athletes jump on force plates. That tells us everything about how they interact with the floor, how they actually produce force into the floor. So we wanna get your landing a little bit softer.
So what's the technique for that?
So when you land, you're landing stiff knees. You wanna be able to break from the knees a little bit. So you land a little lower into your squat. So we'll see if he's loading up the right way, if he's transitioning out of the bottom of the jump the right way, how well he holds force, so how well he can produce force over a long period of time. We're gonna be able to find out how much total force he produces compared to his own body weight. And then that's gonna help me sort of tailor the program to figure out what we need more of and what we need less of. Boom, 27.6. NBA average would be like 32. Now the last thing that we do on our initial assessment is a vertical jump mechanics assessment. So I'm gonna have him jump from a 15-foot approach and touch as high as he possibly can. And I'm gonna see how he's utilizing his positions. You could have all the strength, all the power in the world, but if you have bad jump mechanics, you're not gonna end up jumping very high.
Hey!
Go!
That's it. That's it. So it's really tough to say exactly how much somebody can improve their vertical jump because it depends on their age and their training experience. Typically, if we gain an inch a month, that's really solid. So he's with me for 2 months. I would like to see him gain at least 2 inches, but a lot of our clients gain much more than that. He mentioned that it's one of his lifelong goals to throw down a dunk. So we probably need closer to 6 to 8 inches to be able to do that. So for the next 8 weeks, we're gonna break this into two phases. Phase one is gonna be relative strength phase. So we're trying to decrease Quentin's body fat and get his strength up so that we produce more relative force. We're gonna also try to improve his jump mechanics.
Boom.
Yes, sir.
I'm dying, it's like week three.
Yeah, it's a lot more difficult than I thought it was gonna be.
So today we're at the halfway mark on our journey. Quentin's been looking really good. So for the first phase, the main goal was building relative strength. So keeping his body weight the same or even losing a little bit of fat while building some muscle and getting stronger. So we wanted his core strength to improve. We wanted his unilateral strength to improve. So that's his single leg strength. Very, very important for jumping and for overall health and keeping his knees nice and healthy throughout this process. So in that phase one, we really like to build the base, get his feet strong, get his ankles strong, improve his squat to body weight ratio. And Quentin did a great job. He really transformed his strength. His weight room numbers are up, and now he's ready to actually transition a little bit more into phase two.
Yo, so I'm in the recovery chair. My legs is all types of messed up right now.
So the biggest obstacle that we ran into so far was even after day one assessment, his knees were pretty sore. And that is pretty common with vertical jump training. We completely removed all jumping from his program, and we just focus on lower body strength because we just want to build up the quads, hamstrings, and glutes. Now we're able to actually do plyometrics without hurting his knees. So that's a big win for Quentin.
Yo.
What happened?
You, they said gyms are officially closed in LA County. I'm going to have to put you on the Verco body weight. You're going to have to do it from home.
Yo, this is about to change the game.
Second biggest obstacle that we ran into is coronavirus shut down the gyms about halfway through phase one. So we had to switch him from VertCode Elite, which is designed to actually utilize weights, to VertCode Bodyweight. So he had to do all the workouts from home and, you know, really utilize his own body weight to get stronger. And he's done a really good job with that, but that's definitely an obstacle that we ran into, but he's definitely pushing through.
All right, so we're just switching over to having to do everything at home, and it's definitely a little difficult. It's a little different from working out with Paul, having all that gym equipment. I'm still getting a workout in, I'm still tired, but this is gonna be a little difficult. Like having somebody there pushing you, whole different ball game.
So today we're gonna do a reassessment. Day one, we did force plate testing. We're seeing how Quentin is producing force into the floor on the jump. That's a good jump. Woo, that's your highest jump ever. 3.02. That's three times your body weight in force. You started at 2.5. Your typical athletic NBA player is gonna hit three. You're hitting three. And also on the landing, a big goal of ours was to actually reduce force on landing, because I think that was causing some problems in his knees. It was like eight times his body weight in force every time he was landing. So the peak landing force, 4.35 times your body weight. When we started, you were eight times your body weight. We're then gonna go over, do a one-step jump. Woo! 32 inches up from 27. It's a whole 5 inches in 4 weeks. And then we're gonna do his full approach jump from a 15-foot buildup. Last time it was 30 inches. I would love to see a 33 or 34 today. We'll see where he's at.
Hey! You're up there.
Let's make sure this 10 feet.
Hold up.
Above the rim, you threw it down, hit back rim. I think the dunk's gonna go down. But to make sure, let's put another 2 or 3 inches on you.
Ooh.
So for phase two, we're trying to get him more elastic. So now he has a good base of strength. Now we want to get those tendons really acting like rubber bands, like a spring, so we can store elastic energy. That all comes down to properly progressed plyometrics. So jump training, we're going to do a little bit more sprint training as well. Really everything that's a little higher velocity, moving fast, moving explosive. That's what's going to take him to that next level and hopefully get him his first dunk.
Ain't easy.
That's a fact.
All right, we made it to week 8. Today is the moment of truth. We're gonna get Q warmed up. I'm gonna take him through that initial assessment we did, the force plate test. We're gonna get his max approach vertical. It's a 6-inch improvement just on your standing vertical jump. And then the real moment of truth, we're gonna see if he can actually get the dunk on 10 feet. I feel like physically Q is exactly where we want him to be. He actually surpassed the amount of power that I thought he would have right now. Now it's a matter of getting the pass down and getting his timing right and the approach angle, and everything has to be perfect, because at the end of the day, dunking isn't just athleticism, it's also a skill. And so right now Q and I are really just trying to connect so that I can throw that pass at the right time and he can get up and do his thing and throw it down. First day, you were 1 inch below 10, so you were at this blue right here.
Okay.
Second time that we assessed, you put 4 inches on. That red is your visual goal. That'll give you 10-6, okay. And that's beast mode.
Okay.
Yep. Hey, you're an inch and a half away. This is the one right here. That's it! Let's go! That's 10-6. Wow, you started at 9-11. You weren't even in the 10 club.
Yeah.
You're now at 10-6. You're high enough to go throw it down. Let's go see if you can do it.
Let's go.
It's going down. Synced it up, timing was perfect.
Yeah.
Bounces there.
Let's go.
Wow.
First dunk.
You dunked in 8 weeks.
That's it.
You dunked in 8 weeks.
Let's go.
That's all there is to it. That's crazy.
Honestly, this last day took a little bit more than I thought it was gonna take. But we out here. 7 inches.
Seven inches on the vert.
8 weeks. It's crazy.
Honestly, I cannot express enough how happy I am to say that I can dunk now. It definitely wasn't easy being 5'8", trying to learn how to dunk at the age of 27. Like, that's not typical. I gotta thank Paul for that amazing program. And now when I go back home, I'm gonna fit right into my dunking family. I'm feeling like I can do anything now, so what's next?